t by 2, is that it? So what happen, you have to transform it in Fourier transform or frequency domain. So when you find the Fourier transform, then its Fourier transform is nothing but 2 sine omega by omega, is that it? So have you got this problem, I think? And this is nothing but what? This is nothing but a sync time function. This is a sync-like function, because sync theta is nothing but sine pi theta by pi theta, okay? This is the this formula for the sync function. And we know that sync function is it's like a, so this is like a sync function, okay? So suppose this is x of, well, this is x of omega, okay? But to find the bandwidth, you can see in the previous lecture, to bandwidth, what we'll find? We'll find the magnitude of x of omega, okay? So magnitude means the signal will be little like this. All the negative part will come in the positive part. So like this, it's gone. So here our x of omega, in this problem, this x of omega, mod of x of omega, we have to find. And here you can write this, x of omega is 2 into sine omega by omega, okay? And the shape of the mod of x of omega would be little like this. Is going up to infinity. Up to infinity it is. So since let me write it in omega time. If you write in omega time, then these points are in terms of pi, you will write. Then this will be first pi, this will be second pi. Like that, it is gone. And this also minus pi. This is minus twice pi. Like this, okay? So when I discuss about the non-band limited signal, there I have discussed two types of signal for the baseband signal or low-pass signal. Two types means one is like a Gaussian type, where we can find the bandwidth by using the 3 dB bandwidth or half power bandwidth, okay? And if the signal shape is like this, then bandwidth, you have to take the major lobe only, okay? The bandwidth will be taken by this major lobe, and we have to see only the positive frequencies, okay? To find the bandwidth of this signal, so what is the, here the main loop is this one, and it's ending at pi. So here bandwidth would be pi minus zero, means pi radian per second. So you have to calculate like this. Is it clear or any doubt?
Sir, Fourier transform of t by 2 is 2 by omega into sine omega by 2. Omega will be 1.
React t by 2, Fourier transform is 2 sine omega by omega. But you are saying 2?
React of t is equals to 2 by omega into sine omega by 2, no, sir.
Yes.
Then react of t by 2 means omega will be 1, no, sir.
No. Let me give that idea also. You see here, okay, we know that a reactive Fourier transform is what? Is 2 by omega sine omega by 2, isn't it? So here our scaling factor is A equal to 1 by 2, means T equal to, this is the signal given, and we have to use here scaling property. What is the scaling property, can you remember? Suppose if xt, small xt, has Fourier transform capital X omega, okay? Then x of at, Fourier transform is 1 by mod a capital X omega by a. You can remember, I think, this is the Fourier transform of scaling factor. Here, in this case, what is a? A equal to half, isn't it? In this case, a equal to half. So what happened? You put this a. So first you put the a. A is the 1 by half. So So 1/1/2, because A is in below. So I'm writing 1/1/2, okay, into 2 is like this, and omega, where omega, there will come omega by A. So where omega, there will become omega by A, means here omega is there. So in between you have to write again A, there half into sine, where omega, that will come omega by A by 2. Okay, now you simplify this. Now you simplify this 2 goes half. Okay, then these 2, then these 2 go multiply with twice omega, into sine. These 2 come below. These 2 come below. Wait. These 2, you will take these 2 half. Okay, then what will be case? Half into 2. So these 2 to cancel. These 2 to cancel. Then your answer will be. So your answer will be what? This 2/omega sine omega. So this is, I have written here 2 sine omega/omega, means 2 sine omega/omega. Is it clear? Please look into this derivation. You try to understand things and let me know whether it's clear or not. Okay.
Yes, sir.
It's clear, no? So so up to here, this Fourier transform of rect T by 2 is 2 sine omega/omega. So whatever this short of means function means something sine omega/omega, you think like a sync function. Okay. But to find the bandwidth, we have to find the mode of signal. So when you take the mode, then this negative part come as a positive. So signal is like this. Okay. And we have given, when I discussed the different kind of signal based on the bandwidth calculation, there I have explained this sort of signal also to find how we can find the bandwidth of this type of signal. Okay. Here, the maximum frequency we have to take pi minus zero. So bandwidth is pi radian per second. I think it's clear. Any doubt?
Understood, sir.
Okay. So come to a new topic. It's not too much important, but it's in syllabus. That's why let me give the major main points, okay, of this topic. The topic is some causality signal, okay, or causality system, how we can practically implement. There's the condition of causal system such that we can practically realize, okay? So causality and physical realization. Just you have to know about the condition. Nothing more than that is required. Realization. Since it is in syllabus, that's why I'm discussing causality. So I think you know the causality of a system, that the output of a system should depends on present and past input. So so let me write the simple causality means, or causal means system output. Depends on present and past input. So how we can make a physical hardware, or you can say how we can make a hardware of a causal system. Okay, so in time domain, if we think, what is the condition? So suppose I am writing here in time domain. Okay, in time domain, what is the condition? You can write the condition for causality of a LTI system is what? This h of t, this is in time domain. Just we should know the relation, okay, or the condition. The h of t should be 0 for t less than 0, okay? How it's coming like this, let me explain also. So causal signal or causality, let me explain the causal signal, okay? This is the causal signal only present in the positive means in the right side of the y-axis, or you can say delayed person is x. If this is zero, this is up to positive time duration, the signal is exist, okay? And what is the means LTI system, what is the case or what is the yt if xt is given to a system which has impulse response? So yt is nothing but, we know the formula, minus infinity to infinity x of tau h of t minus tau, okay, and d tau. This is the intermediate variable. So here, in case if you take in this xt, if you think of this xt and if you consider from minus infinity to infinity, okay, minus infinity to zero, that this value will be zero, okay? So this value will zero for minus infinity to zero for causal system. So what will think indirectly? Suppose we don't know about the xt, indirectly we can think that then ht value also zero for t less than zero. So like that you can think of that if you don't take any condition in case of ht, because multiplication is there, that's why we can think like this, that ht also zero for t less than equal to zero. So this is the condition. You just have to remember that for causal system, ht is zero for negative time duration. So like that, in frequency domain also one condition is there. In frequency domain, like this, necessary and sufficient condition. Sufficient condition for causality of LTI system to be physically realizable is, okay, let me write in the next place. This is the must, this condition must satisfy. This is, that's why it's written necessary as well as sufficient, okay? The condition is in frequency domain, minus infinity to infinity modulus of ln h of omega, h of omega also modulus by 1 plus omega square. Okay, this is the condition for impulse response in case of frequency domain, and this should be infinity. And one special name is there, and it is called the condition. This condition is known as criteria condition. This condition is you should know. So have you written this thing? Necessary and sufficient condition for causality of LTI system to be physically realizable is. Okay, so these are two conditions you should know. One is time domain, that HT should be zero for negative time duration for causality system, and the in frequency domain the condition is this ln modulus of h of omega by 1 plus omega square, and if we integrate from minus infinity to infinity the value should be less than infinity. Okay, and this condition has well known name, that is called PNA Wiener criteria or condition. So another simple point you should know, that integration of let me write like that, the magnitude of h of omega must be square integrable. Okay, which another condition is minus infinity to infinity h of omega square d of omega should be less than infinity. This is also one important criteria you should remember. So these are the condition you should remember, and these are condition in terms of impulse response. Okay, so what is the condition for time domain? That is HT should be zero for negative time duration, and the frequency domain, this is the condition that finite, it should be finite value. Okay, so I think you have you completed writing? Let me know. I will start a new topic, that is called correlation. Okay. So class here, please take the attendance.
Yes, sir.
Come to the new topic, correlation. Okay, correlation means it's like a similarity, okay, or coherence, you can name it. Okay, coherence or similarity between two signal or system. Okay, so what is correlation? Correlation is a term come to find the similarity between two signals. Understand? So this is a new topic for you. This is the concept that sometimes we may have to find the similarity between two signal. Okay, signal means if we think that image also a one kind of signal. Okay, so if we, if two person is given and asked me to find the similar to find whether those person's face are similar or not, how you can find? You can find by taking the correlation between them. Okay, so or another thing we often do that, suppose one face is there, okay, one image is there, and in the image we have to find the eye portion, then what we'll do, a crop of eye or eye image will correlate it and find correlation in each of the location of the image, and where the maximum score will find, then we can say that that portion is related to the eye. So there it has a versatile use or application, is correlation. Correlation is come to find the similarity between two images or two signals. Okay, so write the definition, that it is the measure of similarity between due to two signals. Okay. It is the measure of similarity between two signals. It is denoted by a symbol. You can it is denoted or symbol is star. Okay. So we'll apply star for denoting the convolution between two signal, or like in to find the convolution between two signal, we'll use this signal. Okay, static symbols. But for correlation, we will use this star symbol. So suppose R is the value of correlation, okay, and it is finding the correlation between two signal x1 and x2. Then you can write the symbol like this, x1 and x2. Sorry, this is x1 t. X two T. Okay. Then what is the formula? For correlation formula is similar with the convolution, but slight change is there. I'll show that changes. Minus infinity to infinity. X one of T. X two of T minus tau. Dt. Okay. So what is the difference? Difference is in convolution here will be time will come, t will come, and here tau, and here tau will come. But the difference in these three places, okay, that in convolution here tau will come here, and here t will come, but in convolution here tau is there. You can see in the formula. So this is the formula for correlation. Okay, correlation is used to find the similarity between two signal. So the based on the signal nature, okay, this correlation is divided in two types. Correlation can be two types. One is autocorrelation. And another is cross correlation. Okay, autocorrelation and cross correlation, or you can write autocorrelation function also you can write, and cross correlation function. Okay. So what is autocorrelation? If you find the similarity between same signal, okay, we'll take the same signal to find the correlation, then this is called autocorrelation. Okay, and if you find the correlation between two different signal, then it is called cross correlation. Okay, let me write the definition. What is autocorrelation? Autocorrelation function. The correlation we'll find between two same signal. Okay, you can write here SCF. Autocorrelation is the measure of similarity between a signal and its shifted version. Okay, same signal, but second signal may be shifted okay, in time domain. It may be right shift or left shift, and then we will find the similarity between two. But if you finding the two signal same as it is, and there is no difference in time shifting nature or scaling, okay, if both the signal are same, then we directly can say that the correlation would be maximum, or it is correlation giving the maximum value 1. Okay, so autocorrelation will find between same signal, but one may be little shifted version. Okay, it may be right shift or left shift. So autocorrelation has the formula, we know that correlation function, but it is different for different types of signal. What I want to say, it's the formula is different for energy signal and formula is different for power signal. Okay, let me give the formula of autocorrelation for energy signal. So suppose you can write here xx only tau, convolution will find two similar signal. Okay, then the formula would be minus infinity to infinity x of t, x of t minus tau dt. Okay, this is the formula for this autocorrelation function in terms of energy signal, and here you can see that the both the signal are same. Okay, so like in power signal, you should know this formula, then you can apply this formula when some when some problem is given. First of all, you have to find the signal is power signal or energy signal. Then accordingly, you have to apply. Okay, for power signal, let this excess means similar autocorrelation, you can say, or it's similar signal we have taken. Okay, R tau equal to, for power signal it is star will be similar so of t, and the for power signal it is formula is limit t tends to infinity 1 by twice t integration minus t to t x of t x t minus tau, or here no need to write tau, it's t only, all the thing is written in t, t dt. Okay, so slight difference is there. This is not t, this is tau only. T would be this place, their limit will change are here. Okay, so these two formula you should remember, because when problem is given, then you have to know, or you have to find the signal, whether this signal is energy or power signal first, then you will apply, you have to apply accordingly these formulas. Let me give some properties of this autocorrelation. That's very important. Okay, by property, by knowing the property, you can easily solve the problem, some difficult problem easily. Okay, so let me say some properties of autocorrelation. Autocorrelation function. First property is that the autocorrelation function is a even signal. Okay, when you draw or plot in a graphical representation between two signal, autocorrelation between two signal, then that is, that will be as come as a even signal. Okay, so first property is autocorrelation is an even function. So that means R x of tau is equal to x of minus tau. Second property is at tau equal to zero. Okay, tau equal to zero, the function has the maximum value. Means ACF has the maximum value at tau equal to zero below. ACF at tau equal to zero is having maximum value. R x of zero, okay, will be the maximum or greater than R x of any value of tau. Another important thing, this is the important point of the property. The important point is at tau equal to zero, I have said that it has this function has maximum value. Another important property you can see at tau equal to zero is it will give the energy of the signal, okay, or power of the signal. At tau equal to zero gives either energy or power of a signal, okay. What I want to say, suppose any signal xt is given, okay, and question has come that find the power or energy of the signal, okay. Suppose you forget about the energy signal or power signal formula, but there in the hints is given about the autocorrelation function, okay, or suppose a plot is given of autocorrelation function is like this, okay. Four. Suppose this is a function. Plot is given for autocorrelation, okay, and so what happened, and a question has come to find the power of the signal, then you can easily find the power by looking the autocorrelation function plot, because power is nothing but at tau equal to zero, what is the maximum value? It is 4. So you can easily say that power is 4. So this is a very important property, that at tau equal to zero, the value of autocorrelation function gives the power or energy of that signal. Okay, so there are